changing the brakes on Impala. So the brakes are shut. I know the discs in the back are gone. The pads needs changing. Let's hope the discs in front, they're still okay. So we're gonna find out very, very soon. Hopefully when we change the brakes, those lights will disappear. That's for the traction. And then you have this one for the ABS. Also, hopefully we'll get fixed and it'll disappear. So here we go. Let's go take a look at the tools of the trade. This is, by the way, the redneck way of repairs, okay? So here are the tools. We're gonna raise the car with the flat tire thingy. And here's the pads that we're gonna change. That's for the Impala SS. Actually, all Impalas use the same brakes. And here's the disc in the back. We know it's shot. We're gonna check the one in the front, which is a lot bigger than that one. Hopefully still okay. And this is, by the way, the redneck repairs. Here's the dollar store bag. Where's it? We have toilet gloves. So our delicate hands won't get dirty. Okay, here we go. Let's go fix it. Okay, so we removed the tire. And what I do is, since I'm doing it like the dumb way, this is the flat tire jack to jack up the car. And it's absolutely not safe to work under it. So what I do is I take the tire and put it beside it. So if the car drops, it'll drop on the tire. That's better than dropping on you. And here's the disc. From here the disc looks okay, but from the back it's dead. So what we're gonna do is, first thing, to change the brake. And this goes on any car, actually, not just the Impala. What you have to do is, there's a screw from the back here, and there's another one here. If you loosen them, you can lift this up, and when you lift it up, the pads will be inside here. They'll just drop. Put the new pads, put it back, put the screws back, and that's it. In our case, we have to do a little bit more. We have to actually take the whole disc out and replace it with another one, because this is dead. So I'm going to show you how to do it. And again, this goes to any disc brake car. So it's not just limited to the Impala, but we're working on an Impala SS. So we pull this screw. You have two of them. One goes in here and another one goes at the bottom down here. Once you pull that out, those two screws, then all you have to do is just, you can just lift it up, and that's the caliper. Just rest it somewhere. Do not let it hang. It's quite heavy, and you don't want to put enough stress on the brake line, because then it'll start leaking and you're in big trouble. So just rest it somewhere. In my case, I just put it here. And here's the pads. You can just pull them out. And these are the pads. Actually, I still have about 10%. They're not bad. And you pull the second one. After removing the pads, in our case, we want to take the disc out. So this is the caliper. I hung it over here, so I won't put stress on the brake line. So it's right here. And this is where the caliper sits on. That has to come out, so then the disc can just fall out. So to remove this, there's also two screws. One down here, and one just down there. You take them out, and this whole thing will come off. And then after that, it's just a matter of pulling the disc out. And voila, we change it. So we opened the two other screws. Here they are. And now you just, all you have to do is just yank this out. And that will come out. Just remember the orientation, because you're going to have to put it back so you don't screw it up. Actually, it will go only one way in. So here's the caliper. Always when you do this, inspect that there's no leakage, brake fluid leaking from here. Otherwise, you'll have to change this thing. In our case, it's good. And always remember to hang it somewhere. Don't let it dangle, because it's quite heavy and it's going to put pressure on the brake line, and then something could leak and then you're in trouble. Now, this is the disc. In our case, some cars, you can just bang it, it'll come out. In our case, we have a screw here that we have to open, and then this thing will come out. So we opened that little screw that was here. Now, a lot of people will get stuck with this little tiny screw, and I would even recommend not put it back on the new disc when you change it. If you get stuck and you cannot open it, you're gonna have to drill it. If you get a drill bit and drill the head of it, then all what will happen is you can drill it and take it out that way. This disc was fine, so we're not changing it. I put it back in because it's just fine. So we just replace the pads. As you can see, the pads can come off. All you have to do is just put it in. You just have to align it. And that's it. And then we take the caliper, put it back in, and you're good to go. We're gonna check the other side. Probably the disc is the same, is good, so then we don't have to change it. We can return this back. And let's see what happens to the other side. Now we'll take this and put it back in. Now, sometimes it might not be able to, you might not be able to put it back in. You'll have to push this piston. So you'll have to get a piece of metal and just push it. Something like, I could use this tool and put it like this. And you gotta push it like hard, and the piston will go in deep so it can fit the new brakes. And caliper back. Here's the new pads. We inspected their outer, it's good. That disc is fine. And as you can see, it's a bit wet. This is oil. I sprayed WD-40 to loosen it. And then with a soft mallet, I just bang it from behind very gently, not to damage it, and it come off. If it doesn't come off, in a lot of instances, this thing could be like rusted, jammed, and it won't come off. The way to do it is what? Is when you remove the caliper, I had it like up here somewhere, and you remove these two screws to remove the thing that holds the pads, you'll see two screws here. What I do is, I'm going to show you in another video, you can put a screw here with a little nut, and as you tighten the screw will push against the disc and it'll pop it open. So remember, don't bang too hard. Little mallet, gentle banging, that's fine, but not too hard. Definitely not a hammer. And just put one screw, another screw down there with a nut on the end, and keep tightening it slowly, and the screw will keep pushing the disc, and that's how you pop it open if it's jammed, and it's going to come off very easily. Try, of course, WD-40, let it set in, and with a mallet it should do it. If it doesn't, then use the screw method. I'll show you another video. So this one is done. The new pad is in, and that's done. Now I'm gonna put the tire back, and we're gonna do the other side. This is the rear, and then we're gonna go to the front, and we'll inspect the router and everything to make sure that all is good. Now here's the front tire. Since you have it up in the air, there's one quick test that you can do to make sure that your bearings are good and the steering is good. Try to wobble the tire that way. Try to push it. to see if it wobbles. If it wobbles, that's an indication your bearings are gone. Try to rotate it like right and left. You see there's no free movement. If you feel a free movement, that's an indication there's a problem and you should have it checked. In our case, it's solid, it's not wobbling sideways, and everything looks solid. That's as soon as you jack up the tire. So now we're going to remove the tire, check the router, and replace the pads for the brakes. Now before you jack it up, I usually loosen the nuts so then it will be easier to remove them once you loosen the nuts. And every time you change the pads, inspect all these things, because if you detect a problem and fix it before it becomes a major issue, it will save you tons of money. And of course, this is the redneck way of doing things. We're not using any equipment, we're using what's readily available tools that come with the car. Now see, my tire is stuck. So what you do is just gently nudge it. Well, here's the redneck way of doing it. There you go. It comes off. And again, I'll place the tire under the car. So in case if my cheap GM jack fails, the car will drop on the wheel. And here's the router. Now just a quick inspection. Looks beautiful. Shiny like a mirror. So we're gonna go ahead and remove the pads, and I'm gonna look at the router from the other side. And again, there's two screws on each end. Once you pull them, the calliper comes off and you can see the pads, and you just pull the pads off, put the new one, put the calliper back in, put the two screws, you're done. It's as easy as that. I'm doing this wheel with a little bit more detail. At the beginning, I just go very quickly, just to give an idea to people so they don't get bored and watch the whole thing. But if you want to see exactly how it's done, well, this is the boring detail. This is exactly how I'm doing it. I use this piece of metal to make my wrench longer. That way it's easier. You have more torque. So then you don't have to struggle to open nuts. That's why. It's a copper pipe. It's actually water pipe. I got it from Home Depot. So that's what I do. And make sure that when you try to open a screw, that you're turning it in the right way. You're not tightening it and then damaging it in the process. So in my case, I have to go that way. That's number one. That's number two. And that's the caliper. Make sure you clean it from wherever dirt you see. In our case, I got like two pistons for the front wheels. So I don't know if you can see them. So here it is, it's two pistons per caliper. So I'm gonna rest this. So I rest it on the spring because again, it is, this thing is very, very heavy and you don't want it to just dangle. You want to make sure that you rest it up there. So then the brake line, there's no stress on it, so there will be no leakage. And here's the pads. You remove it. As you can see, this one actually is not bad. It's literally new. And I'm just changing them. And that's another one. And the front is like brand new, literally. As you can see. Well, we got new ones. Now I'm gonna check the router from outside. Just feel it. There's absolutely no scratches, nothing. Looks very, very nice. Even the bottom, I'm feeling it. I'm just gonna go inside and just take a look. Yeah, looks good. Let's just put the new pads, bring the caliper back, put the two screws, bring back the tire, we're done. It's as simple as that. Not much to it. Pads that I bought have everything glued to them. Oops. Yeah, have the installation kit and everything glued to them, so I don't have to put this glue thing and stick that little piece of metal that comes with it to reduce noise and whatnot. This one comes already done for me, so all I have to do actually is just put it in. One, just show you the difference between the two. Here's the old compared to the new. I don't know if you can see it, but they're literally both brand new. But we're doing a long driving trip across North America, so we better change them. I guess at this stage I cannot cry about it. I paid for them, so what the hey. Maybe one thing you can do is open up the tire and check your pads before you buy it. That's it, this is done. Now I don't know if you can see it from here, but what I'm gonna do is I'm going to use my wrench and I'm going to push the piston back inside, and then I'm going to take this and push it back inside. I'm going to try to position the camera and show you. It's just simply just pushing it, not much to it. So then it can fit over the new pads. Let's see here if I can put the camera so you guys can see what I'm doing. I pushed the first piston If you notice, this one is inside more than that one. And now I'm going to push this one to push it inside. And then I'll just put it on top of the pads. And we are done. There you go. Two screws back in. And we are done. That's it. This is it. That's the front tire. And that's it. That's the front tire. We'll do the rest. You get the idea. Here's the back pad that we took off, just so you can see. It's not much left on it. I mean, I'd say this is like 10% left. But we're changing it. We changed it, so that's good. That's the front. The front is in a lot better condition than the back. So it's all new now. And that's a good thing. Cars, and this is the redneck way of changing brakes.